Part nine of a very important read of an article posted on geoengineeringwatch.org, written by an Air Force colonel. An Air Force colonel is warning Americans about the atmospheric spraying and the coming collapse. If you have not heard part 1 through 8, go back on my channel and you can listen, then come back here and listen to part 9, or you can click on the link below and read it yourself. Very important information that this colonel of an Air Force, of the Air Force, is imparting on Americans, imparting to Americans, to prepare for the coming collapse. And I will pick up here. Halliburton built or revamped all of our 800 FEMA detention centers. In some cases, legislators allow lobbyists to actually write the bills or acts. In this article, he's pointing out the massive corruption of the American government, our federal government, but not just federal government, state governments, local governments, all levels have been penetrated by domestic enemies. So our legislation is written by lobbyists, and these elected legislators or representatives, they just vote. And their votes actually pad their pockets. If anybody can't see this today, it's mind-boggling. Yes, all they do is vote. And again, removal of several infamous alphabet agencies, starting with Department of Homeland Security, followed closely by NSA, would be appropriate. He talks about in this article the removal of the president, the senators, the congressmen, the Supreme Court justices, locking doors so that they can't get into the buildings, can't get into their offices. This is an Air Force colonel saying this. The process will not be as uncomplicated as it was in 1776. That does not mean that as a group of Americans with a common purpose and common goals, we cannot accomplish what we set our hearts and minds to do. He is not advocating violence. He is advocating Americans wake up and take action. And don't let petty differences keep you at the throats of someone who's different from you, whether it's a difference of religion, difference of skin color, and especially those of us here in this community, all of the fighting that goes on, you've got to rethink what you are doing. But at the same time, the elimination of the out-of-control three-letter agencies would seem altogether appropriate, including dismantling the NSA, and if the people feel it's needed, revamping the CIA, dismantle it. It is or should be a well-known fact that every state and federal representative and senator is, in fact, a corporation thanks to the efforts of armies of attorneys. Judges and prosecuting attorneys exist principally to convict private citizens while exonerating corporations for illegal activities. This is happening right smack out in the open, in our face today. Most police officers are minions of the judges and prosecuting attorneys. All of these people are bonded, a fact which is held in strict confidence for obvious reasons. If, for example, a police officer loses his or her bond for misconduct, not adhering to his or her oath, he or she will never work in law enforcement again, because in order to do that, one must be bonded. Following house cleaning at both federal and state levels, authentic special elections could be scheduled in which the popular vote is the only vote that determines the outcome. No delegates, no superdelegates, or other groups to obfuscate the true results of the popular vote. And you know where I'm going with this, or where he is going, with just this picture. As early as the 1950s, President Eisenhower warned Americans of the potential dangers of what he termed the military-industrial complex. Not long before his assassination, President Kennedy issued a similar warning about the government military industrial complex and the dangers of secret societies in relation to government. At the time of President Kennedy's death, lots of theories were expressed. It was the mafia, the Cubans, whoever. Now, in light of what is and has been going on in America for decades, I no longer believe that any of those theories are accurate. Today, we can name several of those secret societies: the Skull and Bones fraternity for male college seniors at Yale University, the Bilderberg Group, the Illuminati, the elites. By not remaining active in local and state federal politics and government through preoccupation with education, work, raising a family, computers and computer games, Netflix, and the pursuit of other pleasures, we have unintentionally handed over the reins of government to individuals who were only too glad to take them. It is, to me, understandable that the pursuit of hobbies, interests, and other things that give pleasure is natural living in a free society. However, I think we neglected one very important and necessary activity. What we failed to realize was, one, somewhere in that list of daily activities, we should have made time for and included attendance at city council or county board of commissioners meetings. And two, the reins we were handing over were those given to us originally by our nation's founding fathers. Thousands upon thousands of mostly young men, with the vast majority of their lives before them, shed their blood, suffered in unimaginable ways, returned home with mental and or physical handicaps, or died in the field, trusting that they were dying for a nation worthy of their sacrifices. Part 10 will be coming up.